Today's episode is in 3D. On today's broadcast, developers from the top technology providers assemble for a hackathon in Utah. Find out which innovations have the potential to work their way into your business. Advent announces a number of updates at its AdventConnect conference. Which one will help make your portfolio management more efficient? And the SEC wants to see your cybersecurity policy. Find out which provider is offering a customized plan specific to your firm's technology. So get ready, FPPad Bits and Bytes begins now. Hey everyone, I'm Bill Winneberg, and thank you for joining me for this week's three-dimensional Advisor Technology News broadcast. Today's episode is brought to you by the 2014 T3 Enterprise Conference, exclusively designed for the technology needs of broker-dealers and financial enterprises. Time is running out to register and book your hotel room if you want to be in the best place to monitor trends in broker-dealer technology. Reserve your spot right now by visiting t3enterpriseconference.com. This week's top story comes from Orion Advisor Services, which assembled one of the industry's first hackathon events in Park City, Utah last week, called Fuse 2014. Building on a developer retreat originally conceived by Redtail Technologies' Brian McLaughlin a few years ago, Orion assembled over 50 developers and industry heavyweights from 15 of the top advisor technology providers. So what's the purpose of this Fuse hackathon event? Gather talented developers together in the same room, tell them about advisor frustrations, and let them build solutions in less than 48 hours. Top awards presented at the end of Fuse 2014 include Gladstone's Business Intelligence and Valuation Tool, Advisory World's Analytics Integration directly into Orion's client portal, and Orion Advisor Services' latest mobile app for use by both clients and financial advisors. For a list of all the Fuse 2014 award winners, head over to fppad.com/140 for the links to this week's top stories. Next up is a review of AdventConnect 2014, Advent Software's annual client conference held in Las Vegas last week. The company made a number of announcements at its event, so here are the ones that are most relevant to financial advisors. First, Advent's Black Diamond platform continues to mature as the next generation, which some are calling Black Diamond 4.0, received new enhancements to its data mining capabilities, which advisors can now use to generate business intelligence reports on how their business is performing. Also, Black Diamond is delivering a brand new experience to investors through a completely redesigned, mobile-responsive online portal. The updated portal can be customized for each client, will include a secure document vault, and offers a secure messaging system for investor and advisor collaboration. Black Diamond said the new investor portal will be available sometime in early 2015. And Advent provided an update of its Advent Direct community, which I covered last year in episode 107. The community now features over 10,000 registered users who have used the platform to discuss over 700 topics posted by advisors, asset managers, hedge fund managers, and more. It kind of reminds me of a private LinkedIn group on steroids. But if you want to see an example of the latest updates to Black Diamond, you're going to have to head over to Advent Software's website and give up your email address to view a product demo. And finally, this week's episode ends with yet another discussion of cybersecurity and the importance of keeping sensitive data from being leaked on the internet. You can't get enough of that video, can you? So, to boost advisors' cybersecurity defenses, Rightsize Solutions, a hosted technology service provider, teamed up with Stark & Stark, a law firm and legal consultant to RIAs, to create a written cybersecurity policy that can be customized for advisors who use the technology offered by Rightsize Solutions. The written policy and procedures detail what the RIA is prepared to do in the event of a cybersecurity attack, and the document contains information on security policies and standard practices established by Rightsize Solutions. So whether you use Rightsize Solutions or any other hosted technology provider for your business, you need to maintain this kind of information, periodically test it, and demonstrate what you do when the SEC comes to examine your firm. You can get the details on the cybersecurity policy, as well as see stories on Redtail CRM, Finance Logics, and Juncture that didn't make this week's broadcast by visiting fppad.com/140 for all of the links. Remember, Bits and Bytes exists because of the support of our sponsors. So check out the 2014 T3 Enterprise Conference, especially if you're a broker, dealer, or financial enterprise looking to boost your technology for your business and for your representatives. Time is running out to claim your free registration if you're a qualified attendee. So head over to t3enterpriseconference.com for more information. So which Fuse Hackathon Award do you want to learn more about? What did you do to create your cybersecurity policy for your firm? I want to know. Send me a message on Twitter using @BillWinneberg or leave a comment on the FPPad YouTube channel. For FPPad.com, I'm Bill Winneberg. See you next time. So I have to use double-sided tape. Oh yeah, what do you think about that? And we'll include a secure document vault. Not going to be a single take day today, I can feel it. Advent Software's annual client conference held in Las Vegas. Las Vegas? No, I don't think so. I can't do this. What's his problem?